Okay, Scott, what do we need to do to change out the nutrients in our hydroponic system?
Man, first off, we're going to need to cut power to the tote and then drain out the existing nutrient solution so we can go ahead and rinse out the tote and get it ready for a fresh nutrient solution.
Okay, well, I will turn the power off.
Cool, then. Awesome.
We can get started. There you go.
Awesome. Now we just turn the drain and let it start to feed by gravity.
All right.
All right, now we have the tote inverted just to get that last small amount of water out of the tote.
Okay. It's slowly coming on out.
Yep. Just about done.
Almost. How's it looking there?
All right, looking like it's about done. All right, cool. And that is our sign that we're good to go.
Right.
Let's get this out of here.
Okay.
All right, and Chris, if you want to remove the blocks over there.
I can do that. Okay.
Cool, and let's go ahead and scoot this back just a little bit so we have somewhere to.
Just tell me where.
Cool, let's go back this way. All right, that looks good.
Okay.
All right, now we're gonna do our nutrients.
All right.
We're gonna start with a simple three-part nutrient. We have a grow, a micro, and a bloom. The nutrient formula that we're using for this tote is a three-part nutrient formula. Typically, they're in 1, 2, 3, and 4-part formulas. Synthetics are more commonly a one-part or a three-part.
Right.
And in this three-part, we have a grow, a micro, and a bloom, and these are going to be our base nutrients. So these are going to have all the essential macro and micro elements that any kind of plants are going to need.
Okay. And so it's good for plant growth.
Yeah, absolutely. Right. Yeah. And on the back, you can see we have a feeding guide for the various stages of the plant's life, all the way from cutting and seedling, mm-hmm. all the way down to blooming and ripening.
Okay.
We're going to use these cups to measure out our individual amounts, starting with the grow. So right now these plants are at blooming and ripening.
Okay.
So we're gonna use a ratio of 1 part grow to 2 part micro to 3 parts of the bloom.
Okay.
And this is read out as 1 milliliter per gallon of water. So since we're working with 10 gallons of water, we're gonna measure out 10 milliliters of your grow first. It's good to shake these nutrients beforehand.
Okay. It's good to have these little cups here as well.
Yeah, absolutely. It's very handy. And you can also use these smaller pipettes for smaller amounts of nutrients, but that just takes a little bit too much time.
Okay.
So we see on the side here, we have milliliters. Yeah. It might be kind of hard for you guys to see that. What we're going to do, we're going to set this flat on the surface of the table, and we're just going to fill to 10 milliliters right there.
Right.
That's going to be our grow, and we'll go ahead and do the other 3 parts as well. The micro.
Shake it up.
Yep. Micro likes to be shaken just a little bit more than the others just because it's a little bit thicker.
Okay.
Since we're doing 2 milliliters per micro per gallon of water, we're going to do 20 mils all together. Again, flat on the surface.
Wow, that is a lot thicker.
Yeah. Ooh. Let's use the, we'll just hold it like this.
And that's 20.
Yep.
Correct.
And lastly, the bloom. And this gets the most, so we're going to do 30 mils, which is essentially going to fill the cup completely up. Yeah. All right.
Yeah. Okay.
And that is our three-part nutrient. And before we mix these nutrients, what we're going to want to do is pH our water. Back here, we have our pH test kit, just a real simple liquid solution with a color grade scale, letting you know if your pH is more of a base or more of an acidic pH. And typically for hydroponics, we're going to be looking for anywhere between 5.8 to 6.2. And what this allows us to do is to have maximum availability of all nutrients to the plant.
Gotcha.
Cool. Okay. A small amount of water, not a whole lot's needed. As far as the indication solution, just a few drops.
Okay.
Yep, nothing too crazy. All right.
And shake it up.
I'm going to shake it up. As you can see, it's around 6.0 to 6.5.
Okay.
So we're going to be good to go on this.
Good.
So we're not going to have to add any pH down or pH up to the solution.
Good.
So we're gonna mix the micro first, just because that's kind of the steps you take. And this is a 3 milliliter pipette. So I'm gonna do 3 mils at a time of the micro. Added 6, and we're gonna do 2 more because we're working with 4 gallons of water. All right. And that's it for that one. Okay. And you can go ahead and pour that in there.
In this one?
Yes, in the 6 gallon bucket. Six.
Okay, yeah. I gotcha. And we'll stir that. Yeah.
It's important to really stir these nutrients before you start mixing more. Cool, if you wanna stir that one?
Yeah, let me do that.
Cool. Another safe practice to use when mixing hydroponic nutrients is to mix one at a time so you don't cross-contaminate the nutrients. Okay. And also, if you're using small pipettes or something like that, make sure you use a fresh pipette for each one of the nutrients.
Good deal.
Cool. Since we're doing 1 mil of grow per gallon of water, we're going to start with 3. Chris, do you want to take the stick and start stirring that one for
me? I could do that.
Cool. And then the one. All right, that's our grow for that one. And this is for the second bucket.
Okay.
All right, gotcha. And the last one is 3 mils per gallon. So I'm gonna do this 3 times. And
there. Nice double.
Cool. Let's do one more. And then the bloom for the larger.
Okay. All right.
All right, cool. And our buckets of nutrient solution are good to go.
Okay.
So all we gotta do is scoot this back towards us.
All right.
And then we will fill it up.
Yep.
All right. There we go.
There it is. Awesome. There we got it.
All right, and while we have this lifted up, we're gonna go ahead and do an inspection of the plants, make sure that everything's nice. And as you can see, the roots are a little bit discolored, but that's as to be expected with darker synthetic nutrients.
It's a mat of roots down there, though.
It is. Nice and healthy.
Right.
All right, so what we're gonna do now is fill it. So I'm gonna need you to hold the top.
I can.
And then I will grab these buckets. Slowly pouring.
Slow.
Sure,
so far, so good.
Every last bit out of there.
All right, cool.
Okay.
All right.
All right, and that is our nutrient solution changed. Set the top down. All right, matter of fact, before we do that, why don't you plug it in so we can make sure that everything's spraying right.
All right, we have power.
Awesome.
So how's it look? It
looks like everything's working well. We always want to check the sprayers because the salt buildup and organic material from the plants, they tend to clog them.
Sure.
But that's why we have a sediment bag over the pump.
All right.
But you always want to make sure. If a pump dies, then you'll have a dry spot in the root zone, and that'll lead to root rot.
And we definitely don't want that.
Not at all.
Well, Scott, look, man, we definitely appreciate that demonstration on changing out those nutrients, all right?
Yeah, no problem, man.
Thank you much.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. To find out more information on this topic, just click on the familyplotgarden.com link in the description.